Chapter 11. Once upon a time, all the world spoke a single language and used the same words. As men journeyed in east, they came upon a plain in the land of Shinar and settled there. They said to one another, "Come, let us make bricks and bake them hard." They used bricks for stone and bitumen for mortar. "Come," they said, "let us build ourselves a city and a tower with its top in the heavens, and make a name for ourselves, or we shall be dispersed all over the earth." Then the Lord came down to see the city and tower which mortal men had built, and he said, "Here they are, one people with a single language, and now they have started to do this. Henceforward, nothing they have a mind to do will be beyond their reach. Come, let us go down there and confuse their speech, so that they will not understand what they say to one another." So the Lord dispersed them from all over the earth, and they left off building the city. That is why it is called Babel, because the Lord there made a babel of the language of all the world. From one place the Lord scattered men all over the face of the earth. This is a table of the descendants of Shem. Shem was 100 years old when he begat Arphaxad, 2 years after the flood. After the birth of Arphaxad, he lived 500 years and had other sons and daughters. Arphaxad was 35 years old when he begot Shelah. After the birth of Shelah, he lived 403 years and had other sons and daughters. Shelah was 30 years old when he begot Eber. After the birth of Eber, he lived 403 years and had other sons and daughters. Eber was 34 years old when he begot Peleg. After the birth of Peleg, he lived 430 years and had other sons and daughters. Peleg was 30 years old when he begot Reuel. After the birth of Reuel, he lived 209 years and had other sons and daughters. Reuel was 32 years old when he begot Serug. After the birth of Serug, he lived 207 years and had other sons and daughters. Serug was 30 years old when he begot Near. After the birth of Near, he lived 200 years and had other sons and daughters. Near was 29 years old when he begot Terah. After the birth of Terah, he lived 119 years and had other sons and daughters. Terah was 70 years old when he begot Abram, Naor, and Haran. This is a table of the descendants of Terah. Terah was the father of Abraham, Naor, and Haran. Haran was the father of Lot. Haran died in the presence of his father in the land of his birth, Ur of the Chaldees. Abram and Naor married wives. Abram's wife was called Sarai, and Naor's Milcah. She was Haran's daughter, and he was also the father of Milcah and of Iscah. Sarai was barren, she had no child. Terah took his son Abram, his grandson Lot, the son of Haran, and his daughter-in-law Sarai, Abraham's wife, and they set out from Ur of the Chaldees for the land of Canaan. But when they reached Haran, they settled there. Terah was 205 years old when he died in Haran.